In the second game, UCLA faces Louisville. UCLA's Bruins do not have the dominating team of the past, but they win when they have to. John Wooden receives a standing ovation as he takes his place on the sideline in what may be his last NCAA tournament. Coach Denny Crum was Wooden's star pupil until he left to head up Louisville's team 4 years earlier. Crum has the talent, but his team is up against a good team and a lot of tradition. Crum's record is -1 against his mentor. In the 72 championships, Louisville lost 96-77. But this time, he has the upper hand, at least on paper. UCLA scores first on Dave Meyer's jump shot. Louisville ties quickly on Julia Bridgman's layup of Alan Murphy's perfect lob. The lead seesaws. Then Louisville, led by the hot hands of Bridgman, number 10, and Murphy, number 20, starts to pull ahead. At 10-13, the Cardinals lead by 7. Soon the margin is 9 points. Then the Bruins, paced by guards Andre McCarter, number 45, and Pete Trigovich, number 25, turn up the burner. They've taken criticism during the season, but no one can fault them on this drive. They score 8 of UCLA's 9 points. At 5:06, Louisville's lead is down only 2 points. Scoring is roughly even in the time remaining, and Louisville closes the half with a 4-point lead. In the second half, UCLA controls the tip and drives toward the Louisville basket. Carter's shot is tipped in by Rich Washington. The lead once again is cut to 2 points. The teams match baskets for the next 10 minutes. The play is highlighted by Alan Murphy's shooting. And a spectacular steal by Washington. A 6'9" gazelle, he drives the length of the court for an easy layup and a tie. The Cardinals hike their lead to 6 on Murphy's solid shooting. The 6'4" senior has been the team's leading scorer over 3 years. The Bruins floor leader is senior forward Dave Myers. Myers is playing with a number of nagging leg injuries. They might keep many other players on the sidelines. The game is turning out a big one for sophomore Richard Washington. The talented big man plays forward and center. And with Marcus Johnson easily tired, Washington is playing both positions. Louisville's super soft is Wesley Cox, a 6'5" leaper with All-America promise. His quick hands turn this play into 2 points. With 3:17 remaining, the score is knotted up again. And another 1 minute and 13 seconds pass before Murphy breaks the ice. With 1:06 left, Bill Bond gets the chance to extend the Cardinal lead to 4. And he does just that. Visions of victory overtake Bond and the Louisville fans. Washington again goes in the hot seat after he is fouled in a duel under the UCLA board. He makes the first, cutting the lead to three. And then the second, to put the Bruins within just one basket with 48 seconds remaining. UCLA steals the ball, and Marcus Johnson, who has still not fully recovered from hepatitis, follows Jim Spillane's missed jumper to tie the score. Louisville gets a final chance with 7 seconds remaining. But Bridgman's shot misses, and the game goes into overtime. Louisville scores first on a 14-footer by Alan Murphy, who is having the game of his career. Jim Spillane, playing in place of Pete Trigovich, who fouled out, ties it with this baseline shot. The Cardinals extend their lead to 3 points when the ubiquitous Murphy is fouled, making good on this layup. Louisville's first 7 points in the overtime are all his. UCLA stays in there on baskets by Richard Washington, number 31, and Marcus Johnson, number 54. Johnson is one who Wooden has nursed along for a situation just like this. Tension and excitement are running high. Louisville scores on a tip by Wesley Cox, building the lead back up to three. Cox then fouls Dave Myers, and the Bruin senior comes through in the clutch, making both shots. The lead now is only 1 point. Now 50 seconds remain. Louisville goes into a stall. The ball goes to Terry Howard, number 23. He's made 28 straight foul shots. The Cardinals get what they want. Howard is fouled, but the plan backfires when he misses, and UCLA gets a final chance with just 13 seconds remaining. Andre McCarter brings the ball up court unhurriedly. The Bruins work to get inside. They do, to Richard Washington, and the big man comes through, giving UCLA a 1 point lead. The UCLA supporters go wild. Washington in this game has shown leadership and versatility one associates with only a small number of college players. Louisville calls timeout with 3 slender seconds on the clock. Coach Denny Crum works out a last play that could mean victory. But the inbounds pass is bobbled, and UCLA is in the finals for the 10th time in 12 years.